Hello there everyone, Stormy Strike here, and this quick video is about some quick but pretty important Briar news that just came out on the Briarfest blog. So Briar has been doing a little thing on their Briarfest blog called From the Horse's Mouth, and basically each part they're talking about different aspects of Briarfest. This new part, part 6, is talking about a bunch of changes coming to Briarfest for 2020. What we're going to be doing is just going through and talking about these changes on the Briarfest blog. So, a guide to Briarfest from the planning team, changes coming to Briarfest for 2020. As Briarfest grows each year, it is also constantly evolving to make sure that we are providing guests with the best possible experience. We really do read your feedback when you respond to the survey, and we listen to your comments when you talk to staff at the event. We want to make sure that everyone has a great Briarfest and comes back year after year. To accommodate the growing crowds of horse fans, we need to make tweaks each year, and some tweaks are bigger than others. For this post, we are going to outline what a few of those will be in 2020 at our Celtic Fling. So it sounds like there might even be more changes if these are just a few of those that they're talking about. So model handout. For 2019, we added a table in the special run store so 3-day ticket holders could grab their celebration horse models while they are buying their special run models, and many guests took advantage of this. This is not changing, however, we are moving the celebration horse model handout out of the covered arena, and we are moving single day model handout out of the help desk area. For 2020, all 3-day and single day model tickets may be redeemed at the same location. This location will be in a large tent in the parking lot, just past the large pop-up souvenir shop, and will be marked on the map in the program and in our From the Horse's Mouth guide. Models will be available all weekend long, so there is no need to stand in long lines to get your models. Each model redemption ticket guarantees you a model. This does actually sound like a good change because it did get kind of crowded at the help desk because people are asking about things, but then also people are picking up their stablemate models. So it's kind of cool that they are moving both that and the celebration horse pickup into the same location. And it sounds like it will be in a location that's a little bit separate from the crowd, so it won't be as crowded in that area in front of the covered arena. Next, let's talk about workshops. Now, the workshops seem to get moved all the time to different locations. It's just hard, I guess, to figure out a good spot for them. But for 2020, we are moving workshops out of the big barn. We heard that the barn swallows were none too fond of us being in there, and into a large air-conditioned tent in the annex ring, complete with flooring. All workshops will be held in this centrally located tent in the middle of all the Briarfest action. As always, workshops require pre-registration online. So looking at a Kentucky Horse Park map, the annex ring appears to be that ring that's right behind the covered arena. It's the ring where they've been doing the craft activity stuff and different stuff there all the time. So that's actually where the workshops are going to be, which is kind of cool that they are going to be in the middle of the Briarfest stuff. The big barn was kind of a little bit far away for the workshops, but it's kind of nice that they're going to be doing it there. That does make me wonder, though, where they're going to be putting all the other craft activity stuff, because I don't think they mention it in this article about the changes. So I'm sure we'll get more information about where the new stablemate painting area and things like that might be moved to. Unless they are able to still fit it in that area where it was last year. Next is the help desks. As Briarfest grows, we realize that having just one help desk information booth is no longer practical. The tent at the south end of the covered arena will remain, but we will be adding information tents around the park. All of their locations will be indicated on the Briarfest event map in the program and in our From the Horse's Mouth guide, and include Celebration Park near the special run tent, and near the Altec Arena. Here you can grab a program, ask questions, and chat with our Briarfest ambassadors. Look for the Briar-branded tents around the Kentucky Horse Park. So that's pretty cool too, that they are going to be having more help desk / information booths. Next is Hobby Center. We are expanding the hands-on hobby booth to now include the Briarfest Diorama Contest and creating one large hobby center. This means we are moving the Diorama Contest out of the Visitor Center. We are receiving so many entries that this space is no longer practical to showcase everyone's amazing work. While you're in the Hobby Center, check out the amazing dioramas and chat with the incredibly talented hobby volunteers staffing the tent. Many of them have printed information about what they're working on that you can take home. So the hands-on hobby booth, if it's going to be in the same location that it was last year, it's on the right-hand side of the covered arena. And it will now include the diorama contest, so no more diorama contests in the visitor center. I know it's been in the visitor center for the past couple years or so, I think. They've moved the diorama contest around a few times because it just keeps growing and they just keep not having enough room for all the entries. So they are moving it again to the hobby center. And that sounds really nice if they are going to have even more space now to put out everyone's entries and we'll be able to see them better, hopefully. It was kind of nice them being in the visitor center because the visitor center is air conditioned. But as long as it's still under a tent, it should be cool enough. Then there is the raffles. This is not a location change, but a time change. Briarfest hosts two raffles that support the nonprofit beneficiaries we've selected for each year. The Saturday raffle will be called at 4:30 p.m. in the covered arena. This has not changed from previous years. However, we've added a 19th special run ticket time on Sunday at 2 p.m. So to accommodate this, we are pushing the Sunday raffle back to 3:30 p.m. This way, guests have plenty of time to complete their 2 p.m. shopping time in the special run store and make their way over to the covered arena for the raffle. As always, you must be present at the raffles to win. This sounds like definitely another good change, as if you have a 2 p.m. ticket time for the special runs, you won't have to worry about not being able to be there at the raffle or having someone be there for you or not being able to make it over there in time. So now it sounds like you have plenty of time, no matter what your special run time is, to attend the Briarfest raffles. Now lastly is the costume contest. There will not be a costume contest in 2020 before the evening show at the Altec Arena. We've been blown away by everyone's creativity over the last few years, but we just feel like we can develop a better way for all your hard work to be seen and appreciated. Not to worry though, those coveted glossy celebration horse prize models aren't going away. Instead, both nights of the evening show, we are going to raffle off glossy celebration horse models to a handful of lucky winners. You'll receive your raffle tickets at the door, so everyone who is there has a chance to win. No bulky costumes required. So this is a big and honestly kind of a surprising change that there will not be a costume contest next year. But it does sound like that this is just temporary until they kind of figure out a better way to do the costume contest or maybe do a contest that's a little different or something. They will be still giving those glossy celebration horse models out though. Except it's going to be like a raffle, but the only way you can get them is if you go to the actual Celebration of Horses evening show, it sounds like, at the Altec Arena. So if you want to enter for the chance to get one of those glossy celebration horses, make sure you attend the Celebration of Horses show one night. And then the post ends off with, here at Briarfest HQ, we are excited to bring you the best event we can each year. After all, this event is for you, the Briar fan. Overall, I think it's great that Briar is listening to people's criticism and trying to improve things and make Briarfest even better and bigger and have more room for everybody. Because it is definitely getting to be a very big event. I'll try to keep up with any of the other changes for Briarfest 2020 that are announced and do videos on them. I'll of course be doing videos on the Briarfest models that come out and all those fun things. So be sure to be subscribed if you want to keep up with all of the latest Briarfest news. I hope you have an awesome day and I will see you in the next video. Bye everyone!